My name is Joe Kliegman, and I'm a postdoc in the DeRisi lab at UCSF. So right now, one of the project that I'm working on that I'm most excited about is an allergy project. And basically, we're trying to find a genetic signature for anaphylactic allergy. You know, some people are allergic to milk, some people are allergic to pollen, some people are allergic to peanuts. And the problem is nobody understands quite how that works. You know, they know the molecules in your body that are responsible for that allergy, but they don't really know what goes wrong with those molecules. And if we understand what goes wrong with those molecules, we can both develop diagnostic tools to, you know, diagnose and say, oh yeah, like you have this bad allergy. And we can also kind of figure out therapies to cure allergy. So I grew up kind of in on a subsistence goat farm in central Washington State. We didn't have electricity. We didn't have running water when I was a small child. My dad was, I guess, an environmental activist, and he did a lot of work trying to stop a gold mine that was proposed close to where I grew up. And he was ultimately successful, in large part because of scientists who testified in court on our behalf. I don't know, my parents were always, you know, encouraged me to be interested in the natural world, encouraged me to experiment with my surroundings, and kind of due to, I guess, a unique set of circumstances, I ended up in science, and it stuck. A typical day is I come in and try to get whatever experiments that I plan for that day rolling. And that might be, you know, setting up an incubation, kind of taking some patient samples, like patient blood, and extracting the nucleic acids out of the patient blood so I can do experiments on them. An important part of lab, I think, any day of the week is coming in and talking to people.
So what are you doing?
This is a collaboration with the Vail Lab. They have a cool thing. They're doing RNA pull-downs of proteins. Mm-hmm. So I want to use this technique for Vita samples with her plasmodium stuff.
Mm-hmm. Is there something on the surface of plasmodium that recognizes?
Oh, it would be lysates.
Because I think research is this, it's this cyclical process of doing experiments, seeing, you know, the results that those experiments tell you, and then kind of talking about your results with a lot of people that have different perspectives. And you know, I think we're really lucky in this lab to have you know, medical doctors, neurologists, dentists, kind of like people of all different kind of academic persuasions and training. They all have like really different things to say, and it, you know, you might not like agree with what they say, like or they might kind of in the space of 5 minutes completely change your thinking of your project.
No, so the RNA is the motif,
and
then the proteins that bind to it. So what he wants to understand is, what are all the proteins that are involved in this?
I think that people tend to kind of underestimate how much of science is really just talking with people and talking with people about ideas. I guess I chose this lab because having like a lively dialogue and like a lively back and forth, like, for me is like really important to kind of stimulate my own thinking. So I think that's primarily what I was attached to. I mean, and Joe's also kind of like chosen a field that I was really compelled by, and you know, infectious disease like affects millions of people around the world, and he has like a really clear mission statement of helping people from, I guess, like more kind of disadvantaged socioeconomic and contexts in developing nations. So I really appreciated that too. You know, I've done some research that I like, but mostly I think I'm like proud of the people around me and proud of the people that I get to work with on a daily basis. Thank you.